Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about acute pancreatitis injury. Acute pancreatitis is an acute inflammation of pancreatic gland. Bacterial, locally bacterial infection plus minus abscess. Viral, usually from systemic viral infection. Calculus induced, ductus obstruction by sialylic. Autoimmune, acute episode of chronic disease. Juvenile recurrent pancreatitis. JRP, intermittent idiopathic episode of pancreatic inflammation. Most common signs symptom, bacteria, sudden onset of pancreatic pain and swelling. Induration, erythematous, tender, gland, borderline, austere discharge. Patient may be toxic, fever, dehydrated, confused, leukocytosis, weak neutrophilia, normal, slightly elevated amylase. Viral, prodromal symptom of headache, malaise, myalgia followed by pancreatic pain, erythrosis. Swollen pancreatic but not erythematous overall. Involvement is usually bilateral but swelling may be asynchronous. May also experience bronchitis, meningoencephalitis, pancreatitis, ovoiditis, thyroiditis, mastitis, leukocytopenia with relative lymphocytosis, elevated serum amylase, especially phosphate. Calculus induced recurrent episode of swelling, painful gland, usually related to eating. Autoimmune recurrent episode of swelling, painful gland plus dry mouth. Juvenile. Recurrent pancreatitis, recurrent episode plus minus fever malaise. Clinical profile, bacterial acute, painful, enlarged, pancreatic in label. Irritated patient or neonate, predisposing factor, dehydration, surgery, diuretic, anticholinergic, reusing salivary flow, duct attraction by calculus, immune suppression, poor oral hygiene, malnutrition, viral, more frequently seen in children who have not received MMR vaccine. Juvenile recurrent pancreatitis, recurrent episode of painful pancreatic swelling, often with fever and malaise. Epidemiology, pancreatitis is most commonly inflamed salivary gland, likely due to absence of bacteriostatic mucine in its serous secretion. A. Viral, mostly less than 15 years, peak 5 to 9 years, adults are usually immune from childhood exposure of vaccine. Juvenile recurrent pancreatitis usually begin by 5 age, resolve by age 10 to 15, bacteria more than 50 years or nearly. Imaging cut program increase in size and enhancement of what erodite, plus minus straining of surrounding fats, pancreatic to retain normal shape, bacterial pancreatitis. This typical unilateral periparotid cellulitis training is common. Intra or periparotid abscess may occur. Viral pancreatitis typically bilateral. Clinical diagnosis imaging rarely required. Calculus induced pancreatitis typically unilateral. Large dark with intra luminal stone. Autoimmune pancreatitis typical bilateral diagnosis. visceral marker, cyanography for chronic complication, JLA, JLP often need a lateral clinical with bilateral imaging anomaly. Normal main duct with dilated intraglandular branch. See alectasis. This is the ultrasound image. Right and left parotid in a toddler with a right facial swelling, so normal size and equation of the left parotid and overlying sufficient. Right parotid is large and mildly heterogeneous with induration of the overlying sufficient, typical of parotiditis. Axial contrast enhancing, so diffuse asymmetric enlargement and enhancement of the right parotid gland with associated facial cellulitis and myositis due to acute bacterial parotiditis. Contrast enhanced CT, so a low density rim enhancement collection replacing the left parotid gland. There is substantial surrounding fat straining. This finding are consistent with an abscess complicated acute bacterial parotiditis. This is G1C plus MR in a child with recurrent parotiditis, so an enlarged asymmetrically enhancing left parotid gland without significant cellulitis. Note the moderate enhancement in the ipsilateral accessory glandular tissue as well. This is color Doppler ultrasound image of both parotid gland in patient with right parotiditis, so diffuse enlarged and increased vascularity of the right parotid gland compared to the left. Treatment: bacterial parotiditis, broad spectrum antibiotic, high tension, poor oral hygiene, cyanological surgical drainage of abscess, viral parotiditis, supportive treatment, rest, hydration, calculus induced parotiditis, extract smaller stone from that, light proximal stone, may require surgical removal, plus minus parotidectomy. Autoimmune parotiditis, immune suppressive medication, steroid. Juvenile recurrent parotiditis, cyanectoscopy or cyanography, plus minus corticosteroid application. Thank you.